Now we are at the final lap. The last speaker for today is, of course, my good friend, Robert. I know Robert now for about 10 years coming. I've been going to Budapest and having baths and so on and so forth. And now, Robert, you use your
microphone. Okay, thank you very much. We have few people left in the rooms, but that's okay. Who's here? Wanted to tell you how much time I have. Okay. No, because I prepared the presentation for in different level, because I work in really mainstream. So when people come to me, they are in really big trouble. So I always tell my patients, you better be don't come to me, because that you are in really big trouble. Actually, I don't treat no patient with common cold. So when people come to me from all over the world and sit down across the table and tell me their story, and they tell me, I have cancer. Most of my patients is cancer patient. And when they tell me this, I said, oh, who sent you? I don't think you come to the right place, because if you have cancer, you should go to the hospital. So they get 11,000 mile flying, and somebody telling them, well, they come to the wrong place. And what's happening is, I tell them, okay, if you have cancer, you should not be here. But if you have hypoxia, I might can help you. Whew, then they sit back and, wow. So maybe I'm in the right place. So what happened is, I try to explain to them about the unexplainable. We are capable to regenerating power to the cell, to the mitochondria, to turn on the whole cascade, to able to fight cancerous cells by elevating oxygen in the cancer cells and around the and the tissues, right around the normal tissues too. Because I believe we're not attacking the cancer cells itself, I believe we are promoting all the good cells to function right. And they are convincing the normal cells, convincing the bad cells to behave normally. And that's the plan. So I worked with the oncology hospital for 2.5 years, and Cocoon was there in the hospital. It was melanoma malignum stage 4 cancer patients. And as a cancer patient, I got them when they had the last 5 months to live. So for Cocoon, it was not the meaning of curing those patients. It was the meaning of well-being, quality of life, as I said earlier at the oncology hospital. I was really amazed about Dr. Saeed's presentation, because it looks like no matter where this water goes, wounds just heal. Really. And you don't have to be a rocket scientist to heal. You just have to have blood, and you need to get circulation, and you need to be motivated, and then you can get good results. So we get these patients there, and as I said, this is a very interesting case, a stage 4 cancer. They showed up at my place in the oncology hospital. We opened up the 4 beds there, and when the patient showed me this picture, it was very sad, you know. He had metastasis, 4 metastasis in the lungs. As melanoma patient, is not a very bright future. And then had some radiation, and they, of course, burned the inguinal region there. And we put them in the water, and we told them, just calm down. The pain will go away. You know, we tried to explain to the patient what to watch for. And, oh, I forgot to tell you, he's a pulmonologist, so he's really trained doctor. So it was very hard for me to explain to him. He was too intelligent. No, it's really. For a dog, I can tell. Drink it, they drink it, they're happy, and they get cured quickly. Motivated patients, the same way, but doctor to explain the same, pretty hard. So we had to prove, really, we have to prove. So what I did, look at this. After 14 days, when we finished it, he started to get the first good results. All the burns and all the pain, swelling, all disappeared, and it looked like collecting something right in here, like a seroma bag. And we watched that very carefully, make sure there is no dead cells circulating in there. And every day I went into the hospital, I checked him every day. And then after the second cycle, we got this. Now, the quality of life, I think it's there, what the oncologist said. But also what they forgot to say, that was 2012. And today, this man's still alive. And the four metastatic lung cancer was gone too. And this is not magic. It's because he did completely the cycles, 3 times 14 days. Every day, 10 days rest, 14 days therapy again. You cannot accept the water to work if you just say, like Dr. Said said, we put the feet in it. I never see that before. It must coming from your magic too. But I tell you, we have to merge the people in the water and they have to stay inside there. I get them so serious, I tell them, you have to take me serious as you would take your chemotherapy. If you don't do that, don't come back to me and ask me why it's not working. People telling me when they arrive, oh, I have only 5 days to stay. I look right, I make fun of this. I look at my papers, 5 days, I don't see over 5 days. I see only 14 days. That's what the study said. The study said after 14 days, taking the baths and drinking the water, your natural killer cell will grow, your B cells and T cells will be activated, and your cancerous, your normal cells gonna able to help you to recover. I never see anywhere 5 days. So I tell the patient, if you find this study on 5 days, we can do it. There's another case. Also from the oncology hospital, she gets severely burned from radiation. Every day, thousands of people have the sensitive area radiated and they are suffering. They give them creams and they tell them, come back in 2 months and maybe we can continue. The problem is the patient dies before can go back, most of the time. So I want to show you this, how similar the healing, what you showed me with eczema. I want to show you something, or on the burn on the patient, what you show us. This is the most severe burn that could be. That's worse than burning fire. That is burns worse than anything, okay? Because this is not just superficially burns. It burns through the tissue. And when you get radiated in this severe case, the other side of this lady, the other side of the neck, was severely burned, very much burned. So what we did, after 3 days, after 7 days, and after 10 days, it is complete recovery. So the patient survival rates was much better because they can go and get the radiation, but this time they took the baths beside that and used the gel. So that is fantastic. So this patient could live longer because of it. Otherwise, she could not go back to the therapy. And for sure, the cancer would grow. I have some, not just cancer patients, I have some people coming with unhealable diseases by medical terminology. They call them, let's say, atopic dermatitis. This lady has almost 24 years old, and she had always had a problem with that. And all her life, the family could support her. So they took her to England, to the highest level of dermatologist. They took him to United States Mayo Clinic. And guess what? She got the same medication after being tested. What? Professor says the protocol is the same. So can you imagine me when I said to the patient, oh, you have atopic dermatitis? Go to the dermatologist. But if you have hypoxia, come to me. So she says, no, this is atopic dermatitis. I have the medical papers here and the diagnosis. I said, yes, but I think she's hypoxic. So I start to, first I send the parents home. They did not like it. She had to stay alone in Hungary. But I want her to be off with the family, and I want her to concentrate on the therapy itself. So after the therapy, 3 times 14 days, all of a sudden start to heal up. Actually, I took blood from her, and I find that she has systematic mycosis. And the patient, the little boy you showed me, the little boy, you can see the circles around that skin, that was a systematic mycosis. It's coming from that. So when you kill the fungus inside of blood, that they will not produce no more toxins, that's the best way to say, no more toxins, there will be no reaction. So the patient heals up very quick. Just don't feed them with sugar. That's all. If you give them sugar, you're never, never, ever gonna help them to recover. So this lady was carrying it for 24 years. She was sick when she was 2 weeks old. So after this ordeal, finally the parents came back. I let them come back. And that's what they experienced. Now she went back to university. She has a boyfriend. She has a life. And she is beautiful. Not one spot on her. And that was about 6 years ago. Now, it's very strange. She called me, the father has breast cancer. So if I can help the father now. Very interesting. So I will take them as a patient. If they're cancer patient, I can't. But if they have hypoxia, they can come to me. It starts in young age. Pietro from Italy also had atopic dermatitis, and the whole body was covered. The parents was very sad, coming from Italy, and I told them, you have to stay for 2 months. No, we have only 5 days. Oh. So I'm not going to send the boy away. I made the mother go into the water, and I took blood from the mother. And guess what? The mother has systematic mycosis. And guess what? The baby sucking through the milk, all the fungus goes through on it. So he's allergic on the toxins. And that's what's happened. After just a couple of days, they went home. He started to look much better. They said to me, it's enough. We don't have no more time. I said, no, you will come back. So they left. Of course, a week later, they come back because he started to look horrible. And then, after I finished with the therapy with them, that's what we got. Pietro has no more atopic dermatitis, so he don't have to grow up like that. He don't have to use steroids. He don't need to do things where, you know, maybe his hormonal system will get into trouble in the future. And the skin quality gonna be much better. Guess what? While the baby was 1 year old and staying in the water with the mother, guess what? Who got healed by end of the session? The mother. That's why both of them very happy. So this water really touching people's life. Huh? If you don't think, I see this every day. Yes?
Did you do 50 minutes for the child as well?
Absolute. He loved it. He played in it. You know what the child thought? The child thought, because it's 38 Celsius, actually 37, the child feels like, because the child also like a dog, not reading the medical journals either. So he's very open for therapies. Actually, he didn't know he was in therapy. Actually, he didn't know he had disease. So what happened with him, he went into the water and both of them get healed at the same time. And 50 minutes for the child to play in the water, what it feels like a mother wound water, hey, it's not bad. Whoever ever took these baths before, I see some people who did, but somebody don't. And let me tell you, this water, when you get into this one, it feels like you are in your mother womb. You are. You feel on that water. That's why everybody comes down. That's why everybody relaxing. Patients with less days to live, less day. I have no heart to kick them out of the water. Please go home, go home. No, they're holding into the water because they feel that. They feel that. They feel secure. Because when they go into the hospital, they don't feel secure. They feel scared. So when they hear, they feel very much secured. So that's what happened with this boy. All kinds of circulatory problems. There is all kinds of infections. That's all, I call them hypoxia. Here is one. This is just before we went to the doctor, and the doctor said, if it goes like that, gonna be amputated. So I said, before we do that, let's come and do the beds. But they said, the doctor made the evaluation and said, the problem is the colon looks like that too. The colon. So it is not so good. She had a problem to go to the toilet, had runny stomach, has sometimes a long time not going able to go to the toilet. So it's stagnant stool. So it was a very hard condition. And she was 72 years old, so it's very hard to teach her eat better, drink more water. She drink only half a liter liquid a day. So how you want them to function? So we start to treat her. I teach her every day to drink more and more and more, and we end up something like this. The good thing, the colon looked like that too. So now she's very happy. Don't have to amputate, have go to the toilet, and everything goes back to normal. As a matter of fact, her blood pressure dropped down to normal. Did you know that blood pressure don't have to be high because you're getting old? Actually supposed to be lower if you are healthy. But if you eat bad food, you're going to get high blood pressure. Very interesting. They forgot to tell you that. Actually, so many words we talked about today on diabetes. Huh? How many people are suffering in the world? Many? Talked about cancer. How many people are suffering in cancer? Many? Heart disease. How many? Many people. But all I see in television, candies, eat this. I go to the McDonald's, eat McDonald's, eat this, eat that. Isn't that? If I go to the, just for the gas station, did you ever go into a gas station? All you see is sweet. So they feed you with it. They say it's a 54 million dollar to just in Hungary to treat these patients every year, which has been a lot of money. But the income that comes out of that is 10 times higher. So that's why it's a secret not to tell the patient, eat right, drink right, take care of yourself, do exercise. It's an open secret. So let's see this. Oh, this is my favorite. This guy come to me crying, said he's 54 years old. They wanted to cut his leg off. The surgeon said if it goes like that, it will go bad. And what happened here, you can see the necrotized veins around here. That's why this wound could never heal up. And it gets bigger and bigger. The shape is so nice because the surgeon cuts it. The surgeon cuts it very nicely. But smells bad. So when you put him in the water, heals up like that. Very interesting. But did you notice what's changed? Did you notice that? The condition of the veins. The place is the same, the bed is the same, the shoes is in the same way. But only different is no wounds there. Huh? Not diabetic. No, this is just a simple cut, but it could not heal because of the function of the capillaries and the veins. That's why. So the water interferes on that too. So it looks like anything touched by this water, first the odor goes away, and then slowly but surely the circulatory system gets better, and then it looks like all around the world does the same. Start to heal up the wound. 72 times 50 minutes, and we save the leg. So I became very famous in Hungary on never lost even a toe. Do you know how many pictures I have? Thousands. People coming with all kinds of stuff, small things, big things. When I look at the leg, oh, this is only psoriasis, go. We don't, it, to me, it's normal. For a person who's been suffering 25 years, it's not. And this is a real mycosis, it's a systematic mycosis. This young boy come to me, it looked very bad. Both feet looked like that, and all the way up to the knee and the back of the thigh. He come from Italy also. And I asked him, what did you treat it? This, it looks like that. He said, oh, hydrocortisone. I said, really? Yeah, I got it from my dermatologist. I said, and what he said? Oh, he said, put some more on it because it's not going to get better, but start to spread. So I took their blood, and guess what? He had a systematic mycosis called Candida Guillermondii. And when I find it, I said, okay, no more sugar, take the bets. This was longer healing than some of the cancer patients. Took long time, but because the case was severe, he's agreed. So after 2 weeks, like a snake, it drops off the skin. And look at the coloration of the toes. Can you see the color changing? After therapy, we end up like that. Now, if you would have to take antimycotics to do this, by end of the treatment, you would have no liver. Professor says, very nice, die. Yeah, without liver is very hard. But to able to get to this point, from 0 point to all the way here, 3 times 14 days, you know, this is very good. And I believe when a cancer patient comes to me and complaining about having a cancer and have a fungus in the nail, guess what? The cancer healed up faster than the fungus in the nail. So this is my measurement now. I look at the guy's toes. Ooh, no fungus on it. Okay, let's go for control. And guess what? The immune system is working. Interesting, huh? And I also want to tell you, the water will not heal anything. It will not heal any disease. The water is a simple traveler. It's capable to go to cell and releases that lot of oxygen, what we have in there, and nourishing the cells, powering them, restarting the mitochondria, helping on the circulation. Because this cannot be just one reason this wound heals. One time I put 10 different patients in the beds, 10 different beds for 1 month, all different disease. Only 2 things was there, but this was the same. Number one was all hypoxic. Number two, they had all had severe immune suppression. And guess what? All of them responded positive. All of them. So that's what we have to follow, and that's what we have to go. And if we have new idea, I think that bring us more closer. But I believe this is the important part. How much time I have? But how much time? I have time. Okay. So now I would like to speak to you about what cocoon developing right now. In the last 8 months, we put a lot of effort, time, and research on this, about the microbiome and the digestive system. Because we believe to put the oxygen back to the normal cycles and bring pure oxygen to the cells, it's good because it's restoring health. But I think if we take care of our guts and mostly the microbiome, we are able to bring higher standard and higher rates of healing people. I was very famous on the 60%, yes? The microbiome is what is around you and in you. That's all bacteria, virus, fungus, all around you, okay? And every living thing has it, okay? But just to give you a number, about 10 trillion in a human, about 10 trillions of these. So numbers are big, and they're functioning, and they're talking with each other and communicating with the cells also. Just talk to the brain. And without that, we could not live. Some of this microbiome, without this, we could not live because they're fighting. The bacteria fighting against the fungus fighting against the bacteria. We have just 250,000 species of fungus around us and in us. 250,000 species. Not 250,000, just species. And then between that, like Cruzei, Tropicalis, Paracillosis, Guillermondii, Albicans, that's all we know. They are really pulling back our immune system. It was true, virus, bacteria, they can all can constitute to bring in more disease, and the end is cancer. But the microbiome, it's very important. And the digestive system, if it's not working good, that is a big trouble. Did anybody ever felt constipated? Sure, don't put up the hands because I know everybody goes like that. But yes, you want to ask you something? Or let's say bloatedness of the stomach. I'm sure some of us did. I do when I eat milk. Still nobody put up the hands, okay. But believe me, in time, maybe you're gonna get older, you will have a problem with that. Because if you, did ever anybody take antibiotic? Please put the hands up honestly. Yes, somebody did, yes, okay. If somebody did get ever one of those therapies for the full length, then your bacteria flora in your gut looks horrible, destroyed. So you go to the pharmacy and you buy probiotic quickly. 20 years ago, the doctor did not prescribe that because they don't know. No, they don't. Now they do now. If last 4 years. Last 4 years, they prescribe. And not always, but they do. In Bulgaria, they do. Okay, in Hungary, they do. But there is a high brand of Bifidus effensis, lactobacterias. There's all kinds of goodies for the body. But all of them has 4 billion, 6 billion pieces. I'm not going to do slides. I'm just going to tell you, okay? So this species is very good because just like in a border, we have 20 lines in a border, and there is border guards, huh? And you know when you go through, they can ask you who you are, where you're going, what are you doing, just like when we come to the border here. But let's say we have 200 lines, and we have 4 of the bacterias, and they're all asking 4 billion times the same question. What's your name? What's your name? So pretty soon, you just get bored, huh? They're all these guys asking me, what's your name? But the rest of them on the 20 line, nobody asks nothing. So everybody can bring bad things, move in, no problem. Nobody will check. Let's say if I say to you, we bring in 64 different kinds of good bacteria. There is much more than that, but 64. We fermentated them, and then we bring them into the cell, put them into cocoon water, on the base of the water, and we make them drink it, 15 drops in the morning and 15 drops at night. Very fast, your bacteria flora will grow. You're going to be very healthy gut. No more bloatedness, no more constipation. Fat people are going to have very big stool. Really, we know. Yes. Yes, they do. Before that 4 days, they don't go to the toilet. Now all of a sudden, they're telling me, what the hell is that? I said, what happened? Oh, my God. The toilet. I said, okay, so you have to go 3 times a day, then go. So that's what I'm saying. So now we have lots of border guard, very fat ones, standing there and asking questions, all different questions. So now it's very hard. You can pass by, but very hard to pass by that. So what we did, I believe now after 8 months, I actually myself, I've taken it, my whole family taken it, my neighbors taking it, they find out about this, it looks like everybody has a problem. Seems to me. So then my neighbor who never drink cocoon water because of me, because he knows me when I'm from the child, oh, Robert, now I give them this drop and now they're telling me, can you bring me some water? I said, oh, really? The trust grow, huh? Very interesting. So we believe if this microbiome and a digestive system, I'm speaking about the whole digestive system. Don't just think of the gut or the small intestine or large intestine, the whole digestive system from the mouth. Dentists come to me and tell me, can I get this drop? I say, why? Your patient come to me as a dental work, always had very white, very thick, very bad smelly mouth and had full of fungus or something. The doctor tells me something, bacteria or something on the tongue. And after 3 weeks, the patient told her that there is no white spot on the tongue. That's very good, actually. So now she start to take it as a dentist to the, because you know what the dentist do? Just like a urologist, huh? Just look inside, just in a different hole. That's it. And the flora is the same almost. The most pathogens lives in the mouth. So that is very important. Let me just run through this. The microbiome, I told you this. Okay, now this one is interesting. Let me tell you that. People, we go to chemotherapy. Did you know that? What is the first symptoms they have? Ronnie's stomach. Nausea. Yeah, the first thing. Nauseating and Ronnie's stomach. First thing. Why is that? They don't make them swallow the chemo. They give it intravein. Why is that? Because all the toxins gonna go through on the cells. So that's what's happening. They messing up the flora. So if we start to treat them, help them, very fast they're gonna recover. So if somebody in my place, see there's a lots of people there, different nations, and they all after 10 days they'll have red cheeks and smiling and happy and waiting for the blood test. Why? Because we start to replenish them. Watching the immune system, B cells, T cells, natural killer cells, we watch HIF alpha 1, we watch the cytotoxic index, activated T cells, we watch all this very closely. And meanwhile, tell them relax, take the baths. I put them in a hyperbaric chamber for an hour just to have more oxygenation, more pressure. For a short time, very high, but then they come out, I make them drink the water, and they go for about 45 minutes, highly elevated oxygen pulse or pressure. Then in radiation therapies, long-term medication, junk food. This is very hard to do. To tell a patient not to eat candy or sugar or anything like that, it's an invasion of their privacy. Really, they die before they stop. No, they don't. So it's very hard for them to tell them. It's true. And the sweets. So I'm not very happy about this. You know, in the oncology department, when you go to get a PET CT, you have to drink a sugary substance full of sugar, radioactive tracers. You know, you just drink it, and then it gets to the cancer, finds it, and you take a picture of it. Red color, feeds the cancer. Everybody knows that. And yet, in Christmas, you're going to have a lot of chocolate and a lot of stuff. So next year, you promise yourself, next year, you will start with cocoon drops to rehabilitate your intestinal tract and your flora. Okay? I don't have it now, so don't run to me to get it to me. So I don't have it. I just want to let you know it's coming. Okay? And soon as we have it ready. Also, we cannot make a lot. We cannot make by the millions. We cannot make it like that because it's living entities. This is living bacteria. So when you're going to receive it, you will receive it through mail immediately to you, made it in a week or maybe 4 days. You're going to see the dates on the top. You have to use it in 3 months. You cannot keep it. You can't put it away. So it's going to be very sensitive, but going to be very efficient. So this, you see these colors? That's the way our intestinal tract looks like. If we would have a glass body, that's what you would see after all these therapies. This is my idea. Some way it's supposed to look like this. And the people who have young people, many young people don't have this problem, but unfortunately more and more. This is Shandor Fields as a gynecologist, but I've been taught from people telling me more and more children has the same problem because of when more and more C-section, baby born through C-section, they don't go through the birth canal and they don't pick up the bacteria flora they need. That's reason they don't have enough time to have mother breastfeeded, so they don't pick up the good nutrition, the antibiotics from the breast milk. So when they're 2 years old, we protect them so much, we give them at least one time antibiotic in their life. When they get 7 years old, they have no bacteria flora, normal flora. And then we still watch our children, they still wash their hands. So actually we became sterile. Even in the TV you can see, by this 99.9% of the bacteria will be destroyed if you wash your hand with that. Older time there was nothing like that. They send you out and eat what you can, and then you were playing what you can with. And your immune system was strong. It built. Now, artificially hold back. So what we're going to do, we're going to bring this back, restore it. I'm going to be very quick. So, you are what you eat. It's your choice. It's your choice. Dr. Said said, no more bad things, good things, drinking Elo water. Is it? And then everything changes in your blood, everything is fine. You cannot eat something like that anymore. Because it would be, your body would really go against you. Absolutely. So I've been working with this for a long time, so I want you to know, last year, December, I was 114 kilo. Who was in a conference in Las Vegas, I was 114 kilo. I'd look good, but I was heavy. And I had the same problem as you do because of good life. So I said, no. Exercise every day, eat right food, and sleep right. So you know what I did? I went to the Sleeping Association in Hungary, and I became a member of it. There's a little booklet there. There will be a book. Please read it. It's in English. This is about why the sleeping is important. You know, the people, that's another major problem. People don't sleep. Somehow, we don't sleep. Who can sleep the night through comfortably from 10 o'clock? That's very good. That's good. No. But only a few of us, you see. Some people, really honestly, gets up, I think 7 hour, 8 hour, between that length is fine. It's beautiful. But constantly go for 4 hour, 3 hour, not good. And just honestly, who wakes up between 2 o'clock and 4 o'clock? There's some people here, yes. Oh, I did not ask your husband, I don't ask you anybody. The reason I'm asking this, because most of the people who have a problem with the digestive system, they will wake up. In Chinese medicine, we know this is the condition of the liver. So the people who waking up on that time, there is a serious problem, because the sleeping telling us there is a problem. They need to change things. So that's very important. So that's why we need to make the choice of which one we're going to eat and which not. I don't want to get into the digestive systems, the problems. I just told you all this. I just went back to the organs to a little bit to make you understand it's not just one microbiome, not just one bacteria. It has to be treated everything at the same time, all the digestive system, the liver, the gallbladder, everything, pancreas, the small intestines, large intestines, all need to be, I'm sorry to rush, but time is. So that's what we have to go. And we end up with fatty liver. We end up in the same, what we talked about here. Fatty liver can develop into fibrosis, liver cancer, and many others. And then the sleeping disorder starts, is it? And that's where we see there is a problem. Which one is come first, the chicken or the eggs? What do you think? The eggs? And then the chicken? And who put down the eggs? The neighbors? The chicken, okay. So that's why a little bit hard. I have a confusion here. The patient who's complaining about not sleeping has already some problem in the liver, or not the liver, the digestive system. And when they go to test, there is minor problem or major problem. But definitely, one relates to another. And then became hypoxic, like apnea. You know, when you sleep and you're snoring and you wake up every 45 seconds a night, just for 15 seconds, you fall asleep, but again wake up. How are you going to sleep through the day? I mean, a night. What are you going to do at daytime? You run into the wall, poof. Because you're going to have, we call it micro sleeping. 1 second, 2 seconds. Yeah. Our soldiers, we had the same problem. They don't sleep all night. Of course they get aggressive by afternoon. Yeah. And then they fall asleep. And then wake up again. And then get more aggressive. But now they're sleeping nice. They even talk to me nicely when I see them in Las Vegas. So these two together is very important also. All kinds of disorders. We talk about apnea, insomnia, hypersomnia. Just look at the people. They went to the toilet to do other things and they fall asleep. So they forget about what they go in there. No, it's very interesting. The apneas. So all this affecting us, about 30% of the people, you know. So a lot of people are suffering on this. So I decided to join up with this sleeping association because there's 180 countries working with this. It's going to be a new science. So we come out with a book. The book will about 200 and how many pages, doctor? How many pages the book? How many pages? Many, hány oldalas lesz? 300? It's going to be 300 pages. And about 47 page going to be, or how much? How many? Maybe 30 page? 30 oldal lesz belőle, Iván? 26. They cut it. So it's 25 page going to be on cocoon in this book. So just to put everything together, cocoon, ELO, drinking water, reduces tissue hypoxia. We learn this all day long. We see that by the studies. And reduces stress, promoting better quality of sleep. Replaces the entire digestive system. Now, there is many questions in this. I would like to say the first one first. This is going to look like the drop. You will like it. And of course, not all the substances here, but we had to put by law and regulations of the European laws, we had to put it in there. And from next week, we'll be available. So this is the questions, why I'm doing this. I would like to tell you why, because following the tradition, the footstep of Otto Warburg was very motivating for me. The vision and developing invasive, not invasive therapies, so people don't get hurt when we try to help them. And one challenge for me, for God, and that was my daughter case, Aniko. Many of you here sitting here today don't know about the story, but I don't know if it's Aniko is here somewhere in the room. Yeah, okay. So this little girl of mine was 19 years old only. I'm going to be very short with the story because some of you know the story, but some of you don't. She called me up from Las Vegas, because she lived in Las Vegas, and she called me up and she said, I have pain in the stomach, in the back, very severe. I don't do nothing. I don't use drugs, alcohol, nothing. I think I should go to the ER. So I said, go to the ER, check. So what they said, after 2 hours, she called me crying. She said, I have a large mass in my pancreas, about 10 centimeter big, and the top on that was a 10 centimeter pseudo cyst. And that's where the pain coming from, because that cyst was leaking. And then next day, I jump in the plane and I fly. Can you imagine? I already treated many patients with cancer. Many. I helped many people. And God gave me this challenge with my own daughter. And I jumped. I was in panic. For 3 days, I don't eat. I don't do nothing. I just cry. And then when the doctor came out, the next day we went to a surgery. They opened her up and closed her in 2 hours and they said, nothing we can do. Aniko had stage 4 cancer of pancreas. It was a etiole papillary neoplasm of the pancreas. So I was shocked. So I went all the doctors I know, all the professors, and they told me, we can't help you. You have to live with that. So I said no. So I went everywhere. The answer was the same. So I picked her up after the wound healed up in 10 days, just a little bit. I take her to Hungary and put her in my beds against my family will. My whole family was against that. Everybody wanted her to go to chemo, radiation, all those. And I said, this type of a cancer not responding on radiation. So I put her in the water and make her drink the water. I make her drink 3 bottles a day. She was crying. I'm not going to drink. I said, you drink it. If you don't, I give it to you intravenous, but you're going to drink it. So I did very aggressive therapy with her. After 3 months, we had reduced of the cancer cells into a 5.7 centimeter in 3 months. And the cyst was gone. So we went back to the same doctor at Summerlin Hospital, and you know what he told me? Whatever you do, continue to do it. But he don't ask me what I did. So we never went back again. No, really, we decided to go to UCLA. UCLA is much more reputable, much more better understanding of the problem. So after 3 months, so 6 months passed by. She come back to Hungary, 6 months, and by we go back again. And guess what happened? There was 2.7 centimeter, the tumor. Wow. So I said, 2.7? Maybe we can do a VPO surgery or something, you know, because they told me what to do. So we got the VPO surgery done. Everything went fine. And it was 2 hours, 2.5 hours. The whole setup was 3.5 hours from the beginning to the end, the whole surgery. And when they pushed her out, she already was screaming with me, so I know everything's going to be fine. And guess what? After 1 month, we have the results coming back from the slides from the tumor. It was benign. So that, it's true. It can't be changed from malignant to benign. And that was it. So today, I have a pleasure to bring you, Aniko, here to London. After 9 years, please, Aniko, come here. She has 2 kids now, a boy and a girl, and I wanted to say a couple words.
Hello, everyone. Thank you for coming to the conference. It's an honor to be part of the Cocoon family, and I just want to thank God for everything he has done for me, and Now I am responsible for the USA in Las Vegas, and I meet a lot of people there, and my mission is to help and to conquer the disease.
And do you have a cocoon center too?
Yes, I do.
I mean, the cocoon center is Lele. In Lesson.
Yes.
So here you are.
Okay. Thank you very much.
Before we leave, I would like to ask, actually, it's a very rare thing for me, because my family, half of them lives in Las Vegas and half of them lives in Hungary, not because of my lifestyle, but that life is like that. And I would like to bring all my kids up here. I want you to meet them, okay? Because they help us. They help us. If they are here, please come up here.
See, all those bags and everything.
Come. They're all healthy.
All done.
They're all healthy. By this. I hope I can remember the name. All of them. Okay? This is Patrick. He lives with me in Budapest. And this is Norbert and Robert, the oldest one, and Monica. So, thank you very much. They get back the sisters, and everybody working for Cocoon. I'm very happy. Thank you very much coming here. And if you have questions, please don't hesitate.
Right. We are not going to finish yet, because Robert and myself are the fellows of this August Royal Society of Medicine. We like you to see a little bit of the Royal Society. I'll tell you something. We have one of the best library upstairs. There is very good hotel accommodation, and so on and so forth. You are most welcome to have a small visit. Robert is a fellow here, so we will go around and show you. And the same applies to you. Now, one more minute. As you know, we will be finishing in, say, 5 minutes. Ask questions, anything you want.
Okay, before we do that, I would like to have Ron stand up, please. Ron Skull, please. He's one of our sponsor here, and he is one of our Cocoon representative in England. And please give him a big pause. Because and if you have any question about people who lives here in this area, he's the man. In dinner, you can catch him, or he can give all the information about him. And thank you very much for having us here. And thank you so much. Lovely wife, Mary, the son, everybody here. Thank you very much. They are big Cocoon family.
Yes.
Any question you have?
Right. Questions, please. Yeah.
I was just curious to find out more about the kind of maintenance therapy. So if you have approached like acute conditions, I mean chronic conditions, but in very serious stage with an aggressive type of treatment, and then once you've got them out of that kind of emergency situation, what's the sort of ongoing maintenance treatment that you propose?
We always tell the patients if it's acute the problem to consult with their physicians. That's very important, so we don't put the physicians out of it. Once we establish the patient has very good, let's say, vital forces and good blood work and not so good blood work, but still strong and have strength, then we do our own evaluation. I had no time to talk about my special blood test. Maybe next year I will say more about it, but many people just traveling just for the blood test. Because I can see things now what no other can see about function of natural killer cells, B cells, T cells. I can see vitamin C in the tissue. I can see in the plasma. I can see HIF alpha 1. So many things I can see what you don't get to the regular blood test. So my patients come there 0 day. They take the blood, and then we do the therapy. And then when they leave, we do it again. So I send them after them. Once we have the results, we compare it, okay? So we can handle that situation. We have doctors on sides, and we can always help that.
I just have a quick question. You said that it's treating underactive immune system, but what about when it's overacting, like in autoimmune diseases? Would you recommend to someone to use
No, very good question. When
it's about overactive immune system. Would you recommend to someone who has autoimmune disease like rheumatoid arthritis?
The first what we countered is a lot of people in Hungary. 1 million people have allergies. You know, this is overreacting on something. So what we tell them to do, to drink very responsibly. First year, just drink half a liter. The second year, drink 1 liter, and then end up to 1.5 liter. But when they head up there, it seems the syndromes are going down, 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 down. So actually, you get into balance. But definitely, people with transplantation of kidney or heart or liver, we are not recommend them to drink it constantly. It's not good, because it could trigger the natural killer cells to grow. That's a good question, Walid. Yes? From New York.
Can you please clarify the statement when you open a cocoon bottle that the oxygen leaves after 3 days? Or?
Oh, yes, that was a question. If you have, maybe somebody don't, under, maybe I did the wrong impression on it, but when you open the water and leave it for 3 days open, the oxygen stays there. After that, it starts to going down, 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 down slowly. In 7 days, it will go out of it. Not completely, can never release all the oxygen, but the O2s, what Chandra was talking about, it will deplete. But I tell you, when you open it and you drink it, you don't leave it like that, you close the top. It could be months like that, but nobody keeps it that long. Nobody, in 3 days, me, myself, I drink it all day long. Somebody told me today had a problem when they drink the water, had to go to pee very often. Huh? You know why? Because there is two function of the bladder. One part is when it's full, you can hold it back. You can wait until you get home. You can wait until you go to the toilet. But with cocoon is different, because when the toxins comes to you and the toxins releases into the bladder, you cannot hold it back. You have to go to pee. You can't hold it. That you cannot hold. And that's what you know cocoon water is working. When you go to pee often in the beginning, because the toxins will tell you have a lot of toxin in your body. But soon as me, I can drink whole bottle, really normal pattern. But people who just started it, they do. One time I went to a TV show and the guy said, he said, oh, I've been 30 years being a reporter. And I said, what is this water? I tell him about, be careful, don't. He thought I'm telling him because I don't want him to drink the water. So he just started to pour it. And about 15 minutes in live show in TV, he goes, okay, I have to go. That's what happened. So be responsible when you drink it. Okay?
Yeah.
It's many practitioners here. If the people interesting about that, we have the way to contact us. We can feed you with information. Yes?
Do you plan to bring a spa to the UK?
Yes, we do.
When?
Soon.
We How
are,
soon?
No. We are really, just like General said, we have about 18 new centers will open in the US next year. We are planning to do one in Paris, one in London for sure. So we're going for it, but it's not easy to find the place, the right people in it, because this is completely new. Once we find the right people, the right person, we will be here. Until that, you are only 2-hour flight from Hungary, jump on the plane, but I will ask you, are you hypoxic or you have a disease? Don't forget it. The answer, I'm just hypoxic. Thank you very much for attention. All the presenters, Anna, everybody, thank you very much. Dr. D, and come to dinner. The dinner gonna be, who signed up for the dinner at the House of Lords, please, what time be there at 7?
7 o'clock.
7 o'clock.
Which entrance or where? When you come to House of Lords, one entrance.
It's only one entrance for the Lords. You guys gonna be the Lords and ladies.
The Lords.
Thank you, so, yes?
What?
Oh, here is the information. Thank you very much coming. Yes, one more question? Oh, okay.
How about a hand for our chairman, Sam Linger?
Yes.
Thank you very much.
It was a very good job. It was a very good job.